أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، أيها الأحبة في الله، أشهد الله تعالى أن يحبكم في الله جميعا، وأسأله تعالى أن يجمعنا في الجنة مع النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جمعنا في الدنيا على طاعته. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I make Allah bear with you that I love every one of you for the sake of Allah, and I ask Him to gather us in the Jannah with the Prophet Muhammad as He has gathered us in this dunya to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the beginning of my khutbah, I want to make dua for some brothers who are sick. One of them, whose name is Sayyid Warish Hussain, he's in a critical situation. And the other brother, Iqbal Ansari, he had a heart attack 2 days ago, and he is now in the hospital, and you should go to visit your brother. And inshallah, now we're making dua for them, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them, to heal them inshallah. اللهم رب الناس أذهب البأس اشفي وأنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا يا رب العالمين وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وبعد، the respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we are still talking about that important topic that every one of us needs to know about. We're talking about the signs of accepted good deeds. And last Friday I mentioned 4 signs that the scholars mentioned. And we said no one in this world can guarantee that your good deeds are accepted by Allah or refused. It's only up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who decides whether your good deeds are accepted or not subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I prepared for you 10 signs I mentioned last Friday, 4 of them, and today we will mention the rest of them inshallah. The first sign was when you are in the state of mind. Like you always think, you are always worried if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts your good deeds. If Allah sees you that you worry about your good deeds, inshallah He will accept you. Number 2 is that the person doesn't return back to do bad deeds after doing good deeds. It's also one of the signs of accepted good deeds by Allah. Number 3 is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the ability to do more good deeds after doing that one good deed. So if you increase your good deeds, it's a sign that you're accepted. And the last one was when you do a lot of good deeds, you do not feel proud of yourself, but you're always humble and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept you. And we ask Allah to accept all of us. Allahumma ameen. The 5th sign of accepted good deeds, because during Ramadan you always worship Allah, increase your ibadat. How can I know if Allah accepted me or not? Number 5, the believer ends up loving good deeds. Like you feel or you taste the sweetness of the good deed that you always do. You love the good deed, you start loving to come to the masjid, you start loving to fast in Ramadan. Like if you ask some brothers at the beginning of this month, even myself, how is Ramadan going so far, akhi? He will say to you, like, it's too hard because it's hot here and we have long days. We fast about 18 hours a day. And I go to work and And then I come back from work very exhausted. I can't stand. It's really difficult. And at night I have to pray 20 rak'at or at least 8 rak'at for Taraweeh. Then I have to recite Quran because in the month of the Quran, he feels like it's a little bit hard. But after some time, he starts to love the good deeds. And Allah helps him to do that. The Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he mentioned the 7 kinds of people who will be in the shade of the throne of Allah on the day of resurrection, when there is no any other shade except him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّ. 7 kinds of people will be under the shade of the throne of Allah on the day of resurrection. And one of them, رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. A man or woman, definitely, whose or her heart is connected to the masjid. Whenever he is at home, he is at work, and he knows that the time of the prayer is closer, he feels like he wants to go to the masjid. He loves, you know, today you have halaqah for the ground, for example. He loves the halaqah and he's preparing himself for the halaqah, waiting for its time. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, when the time of the prayer comes closer, approaching him, he used to say to his al-mu'adhdhan al-azim, his best mu'adhdhan Bilal radiallahu anhu, أَلِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال نَادِي الصَّلَاةِ وَأَلِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال. Because the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he used to have 3 مؤذنين, سيدنا بلال, عبدالله بن أم مكتوم, and أبو بحذورة. And the first of them who had the most beautiful voice among the Sahaba was سيدنا بلال. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام used to say to him, بلال, give us ease by giving the call to prayer, by giving the adhan. He loves to hear the adhan even, صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he also said to the Sahaba, teach them to love the ibadah. قال وجعلت قرة عيني في الصلاة. Like a salat been made the most beloved thing in this world to my heart. صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, salat has been made the delight of my eyes. The delight of my eyes. You can imagine how much he used to love it. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran talked about the people who increase adhkar or dhikr Allah azza wa jalla, who increase mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like some people just mention Allah after the prayer in the morning and evening, adhkar al-salahi wal-masa'. But some other people, they always, when they are in the bus going to work, they are driving, they are waiting in governmental facility or anywhere, they just mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See them always mention God subhanahu wa ta'ala. These people really love remembering of Allah, and Allah most likely accepted them. قال الله عز وجل الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. Those who have believed and whose hearts are assured by the members of Allah, no doubt by the members of Allah the hearts are assured. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all love His ibadah. Allahumma ameen. قال الله عز وجل in Surah Al-Hujurat, to teach us that loving good deeds and hating bad deeds is just a bounty from the bounties of Allah. It is the favor of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله تعالى وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهِ. This part of the ayah from the beginning, قال تعالى وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لَوْ يُطِيعُكُمْ فِي كَثِيرٍ مِنَ الْأَمْرِ لَعَنِتُّمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانَ وَزَيَّنَهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمْ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصْيَانَ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الرَّاشِدُونَ فَضْلًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَنِعْمَةً وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ but Allah has endeared to you the faith and has made pleasing in your hearts and has made hateful to you disbelief and disobedience towards Allah. Those are the rightly guided people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made Iman beloved to your heart subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that beautiful dua that we always should say, Allahumma habbib ilayna al-imana wa zayyinhu fi qulubina wa karrih ilayna al-kufra wa al-fusuq wa al-'isyan. We should ask Allah the same, oh Allah, make Iman beloved to our hearts and decorate Iman our hearts and make us hate, disbelief, and disobedience towards you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, فَضْلًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَنِعْمًا. It is only a bounty from Allah and favor, and Allah is knowing and wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Sign number six, that your good deeds are accepted by Allah. The person is hopeful in Allah's mercy and makes a lot of dua that Allah accepts his good deeds. Last Friday we talked about al-khawf. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said, لَوْ نَزَلَ مَلَكٌ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَقَالْ كُلُّ النَّاسِ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا عُمَرْ لَخَشِيْتُ أَنْ إِلَّا وَاحِدًا لَخَشِيْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَنَا هَذَا الْوَاحِدِ. If an angel to be sent down from the heaven to call people, everybody to enter paradise, to one person, I would have been told that I am that person. I am that person. But today we are talking about the other way of the believer when he flies to the paradise on his way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is hope in Allah's mercy. إِنَّ الْخَوْفَ وَحْدَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ لَا يَكْفِي لَنَّ الْخَوْفَ وَحْدَهُ يُؤَدِّي إِلَى الْيَأْسِ وَالْقُنُوتِ. If you only fear Allah, it's not enough. Because you will become hopeless of Allah's mercy. And it's a kind of sin. قال الله عز وجل إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. In Surah Yusuf, indeed no one despairs of relief from Allah except the disbelieving people. And on the other hand, if you only have a raja, but you don't have khawf, it doesn't go like that too. Because now, أَنْتَ تَأْمَنُ وَكْرَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. On the other hand, if you only hope Allah's mercy, but you don't have any fear from Allah, now you feel safe with the plans of Allah, it's very dangerous. قال الله عز وجل في سورة الأعراف أن أمنوا مكر الله فلا يأمن مكر الله إلا القوم الخاسرون. Did they feel secure from the plan of Allah? But no one feels secure from the plan of Allah except the losing people, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Ummah used to say a very beautiful sentence, you have to always memorize it. رُبَّ طَاعَةٍ أَوْرَثَتْ عِزًّا وَاسْتِكْبَارًا وَرُبَّ مَعْصِيَةٍ أَوْرَثَتْ ذُلًّا وَانْكِسَارًا. Listen to it carefully. Like, perhaps an obedient person towards Allah, but he is arrogant. He feels proud of himself. He always worships Allah. He always comes to the masjid. He memorizes the Quran, like he's arrogant. This kind of ta'a, it makes him arrogant, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most likely won't accept him. But on the other hand, وَرُبَّ مَعْصِيَةٍ أَوَاتٍ قُلًا وَانْكِسَارٍ. A man who is disobedient towards Allah, but he can't abstain from bad deeds, but is asking Allah to help him. It is very difficult for him. Allah most likely will accept it because he's trying, but he can't. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, while building the first house of this world to worship Allah, used to ask Allah to accept it from him. قال الله عز وجل وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. A mention of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ibrahim was raising the foundations of the house and with him his son Ismail, saying, O our Master, O Allah, accept this action from us. Indeed, you are the hearing and knowing. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sign number seven, that your good deeds are accepted by Allah. Performing good deeds becomes easier for the individual. Like as I just mentioned, when you start at the beginning to recite the Quran, it is very difficult, especially if it's not your first language. It is very difficult for you. It is very difficult to fast in that long days, that hot days. But if you blind yourself, you strive for the sake of Allah, it will become easier. So if you see yourself, it's easier for you to commit sins. Like it's easier to commit zina, fornication. It's easier to eat riba, to eat usury. It's very easy for me to smoke cigarettes. It's easy for me to commit any kind of sin. Make sure that Allah most likely doesn't accept your good deeds. But on the other hand, if you find it's very easy for you to come to the masjid, it's very easy to recite one juz every day or two juz this evening, it's very easy for you to worship God, it's an evidence that Allah has accepted you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have an evidence in the Quran, قال الله عز وجل فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَى بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنْيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. As for he who gives for the sake of Allah and fears Allah and believes in the best rewards, we will ease him towards ease. Allah will easier for you. And on the other hand, وَأَمَّا مَنْ دَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. But as for he who withholds, he doesn't give for the sake of Allah, and considers himself free of need, he doesn't need the reward, and denies the best reward, we will ease him towards difficulty. It will be easy for him to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 8. To love those who are righteous and to hate those who are evil. If you love the pious people and you hate the disobedient people, it's an evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, insha'Allah, accepts your good deeds. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المرء على دين خليله فلينظر أحدهم من يخالل. The man is on the religion of his friends. So look at who you become friends with. أخبرني من تصاحب أقول لك من أنت. If you tell me about your friends, I can't tell you who you are. If you tell me about your friends, I can't tell you who you are. Or even you can mock yourself. You can see the people whom you love to sit down with, whom you love to socialize with, whom you love to hang out with, whom you always love to consult them to take their opinion about your affairs in this dunya. So these people will affect you anyways, directly or indirectly. So be very careful. If you love the righteous people and you hate the bad people who disobey Allah, it's an evidence that you're accepted by Him, subhanahu, inshaAllah. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي رواه أحمد عن البراء بن عازب إن أوثق عرى الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله. Reported by Imam Ahmad through البراء بن عازب that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, verily the strongest of hand of faith is that you love for the sake of Allah and that you hate for the sake of Allah. من أحب لله وأبغض لله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. Whoever loves for the sake of Allah, hates for the sake of Allah, gives for the sake of Allah, withholds for the sake of Allah, now it's an evidence that he has a real, complete iman. So everything for the sake of Allah. إذا أردت أن تعلم عند الله مقامك فانظر فيما أقامك. The scholars used to say, if you want to know your position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the akhirah, just look at your position in this dunya. Look at the people you always socialize with and you can know your position in the akhirah. Just simply like this. So, number 9, to increase your istighfar. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. InshaAllah, I mentioned that after jilsatul istiraha. وَقُلْ قُلْ يَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله حمد الحمد والشكر له شكرا شكرا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I can remember one of our old scholars. We always used to say Astaghfirullah Alhamdulillah, Astaghfirullah Alhamdulillah, Astaghfirullah. Whenever you see him, like he's waiting for anything. He's not doing anything, he's not studying, he's not giving a lecture. Just say it like that, waiting for something. So he always says, Astaghfirullah, Alhamdulillah. And when he was asked about that, he said, because the person or the human being in this world, he lives between his sins and the bounties of Allah. So when I remember my sins, I ask Allah to forgive me. Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. And at the same time, Allah is most merciful towards me, and I'm sinful. So I say, Alhamdulillah, 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 praise be to Allah, praise be to Allah. So always increase his thanks. Astaghfirullah is one of the best kind of adhkar, you can say. Actually, the adhkar is like a plate of fruits. You have variety of fruits. You can choose whatever you want. But for istighfar especially, if you increase your istighfar especially after ibadat, it's an evidence that you are, insha'Allah, accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why after the prayer, you're praying now, alhamdulillah, you were reciting the Quran, you were making ruku', sujood, listening to the imam reciting the ayat, you may be even crying, if you're closer to Allah, and immediately after salam, أستغفر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله نسيت أستغفر الله أستغفر الله أستغفر three times so what when you do any kind of sin when you commit any sin actually not you want to worship Allah but Allah is teaching us after the good deeds make istighfar so I will accept it from you. That maybe anything wrong you have done during the prayer which you do realize, just asking to forgive you, he will accept that. And also after the righteous ritual of Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ثُمَّ أَفِيضُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسُ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهُ غَفُورٌ. After Hajj, that forgives all of your sins, all of your sins, you also ask Allah to forgive you. SubhanAllah. قَالَ تَعَالَى Then depart from the place from where all the people depart and ask forgiveness of Allah after Hajj. Indeed, Allah is forgiving and merciful. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last sign I would mention is consistency of doing good deeds. Consistency of doing good deeds. And I have a glad tidings for you from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The scholars always used to say, try to increase your good deeds when you are young. Like especially for my young brothers and sisters in Islam. When you're young, in your teens, in your 30s, try to increase your good deeds. Because one day you may become sick, you may become patient. You may become older, and you won't be able to do the same kinds of ibadah that you used to do in your health conditions. Like, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث عظيم رواه الإمام البخاري very beautiful hadith reported by الإمام البخاري إذا مرض العبد أو سافر كتب الله له أجر ما كان يعمل صحيحا مقيما. If a person is traveling or he is sick and he can't worship Allah as he used to worship him while not traveling and healthy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him the same. Allah will give you the same reward. You can't imagine that. Look at the mercy of Allah. It's a hadith reported by Imam Bukhari. So consistency of doing good deeds is a sign that Allah will accept it from you even if you can't. Because you became sick or you traveled or anything. So now we have 10 signs for our good deeds, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of us in Ramadan. Allahumma ameen wa inni da'in fa'aminu. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin fi awalim, salli alayhi fi al-akhirin, wa ala alihi wa sahabati ajma'in, wa alayna ma'ahum ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma taqabbal minna, Allahumma taqabbal minna, Allahumma taqabbal minna. وعلى طاعتك أعنا ومن شرور خلقك سلمنا ومن فضلك لا تحرمنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا واهد أعداءنا واهد أعداءنا ولا تخيب فيك رجاءنا وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وأقم الصلاة.